In this screencast, we're going to find the rate of generation of heat in a wall that is insulated on one side and subjected to convection on the other. So our temperature distribution for this type of system is T of X equals Q dot, which we're looking for, over 2K, where K is the thermal conductivity, L squared, which is the length of the wall, minus X squared. So at our X equals zero, our T equals a maximum. So let's rewrite that in terms of our rate of heat generation, Q dot, which equals T max times 2 times K divided by L squared. So let's look at this when we put in some numbers. Let's say we have a T max equal to 600 K. Our thermal conductivity is 25 watts per meter K, and the length of our wall is 0.1 meters. So our Q dot is going to equal 600 K times 2 times 25 watts per meter K, all divided by 0.1 meter squared. And when we calculate that, we come out with 30 times 10 to the fifth watts per meter cubed. So why is it per meter cubed? Well, generation is a volumetric phenomena because it happens within that volume. So our units are going to be watts, which is joules per second, per meter cubed. So now that we have our rate of generation, let's see what the surface temperature is. In order to find that, we need to know what the bulk temperature, or T infinity, is, which is 200 K, as well as what our convective heat transfer coefficient is, which is 1,000 watts per meter squared K. So since we know at X equals L, Q double prime, that's the heat flux that's conductive, equals the heat flux that's convective. So we can write this as minus K dT dx equals H times TS minus T infinity. Minus K dT dx equals Q dot times L, and now we divide this by H, add T infinity to it, and we end up with an expression for our surface temperature. Again, let's put in some numbers for this. This is the heat generation we found earlier, 30 times 10 to the fifth watts per meter cubed, and we multiply that by 0.1 meters. And this is all divided by that convective heat transfer coefficient, 1,000 watts per meter squared K. This is added to 2,000 K, and our surface temperature is equal to 300 K plus 200 K, or 500 Kelvin. Note that temperature had better be somewhere between our T max, which we said was 600 K, and our bulk temperature, which is 200 K, and at 500 K, this makes sense.